Hello, this is Bern, and on today's episode, I'm going to share with you what makes a man commit to only one woman. Hello, and welcome to another edition of BernMendez.com, a space where I share with conscious, ambitious, heart-centered, successful women how you can attract the man you want and the relationship you want without the need for gimmicks, manipulation, tricks, or BS. As I'm exploring this topic with you, what does it really take for one man to commit to only one woman and stop the nonsense of the endless search and stop the cold feet and the I'm not sure if I can do this? What does it really take? Well, there's going to be some qualities that are required in you and some qualities that are required in him. Let's start with him, because as you have probably experienced in life, not all men fit this category, right? So the first quality you need to experience in him, he needs to be the type of guy who has emotional maturity. Now, what does that mean in the context of committing to a woman? He needs to understand at a deep level that meaning in life is greater than, more important than, more fulfilling than, in the end, pleasure. Why is that important? Because committing to one woman means he's gonna have to say no to his urges and his feelings of pursuit for other women, and the chase, the whole thing that he's feeling emotionally, innately, that it's part of his DNA, spreading the seed around the world. He needs to stop that nonsense and he needs to focus on one human being. For that, he needs to be able to see the future and understand that sacrifice, in some ways, creates a bigger level of fulfillment down the line. So that's the first quality he's gonna need to have. A vision of meaning is more important than pleasure. Second thing he's gonna need to have is discipline. Why? Because he's gonna have to do what needs to be done in several moments throughout a relationship, including if he decides to have a family with you, for example. Discipline is an important skill to make things happen, to create a life for yourself, to create financial fulfillment and freedom, to be a father, to be a leader. Third one is generosity. Why? Because generosity states at its core, life isn't about me. And when I give, when I contribute, my heart sings and dances in a more powerful way than if I just focus on myself. So those are three things the guy you connect with will need to have: generosity, discipline, and emotional maturity. Now, for you, what does it take for him, that type of man, to commit to you, not somebody else? First thing it's gonna need on your part is worth. Your feeling of what you have to offer, not intellectually, but from your heart, that allows you to have standards, to set boundaries, to be confident, to be self-expressed. So when you have worth, here's what happens. He connects with you, great guy connects with you, you have worth. He says, wow, if this woman who has worth, who is valuable, who not just me, but other people will want because she's valuable, is paying attention to me, that makes me a more valuable human. If you don't feel great about yourself, if you feel down, if you hate your body, if you don't feel that level of confidence and worth inside yourself, then him being with you means that someone who's not paid attention to by anyone, someone who's not really worthwhile, is with him, which makes him less valuable. It's psychological logic, I guess. Second thing he's gonna need from you, he's gonna need clarity versus drama, clarity versus games, directness versus turnaround, hypothetical, treasure hunts. So that means in communication, when things are unclear to you, when you're not feeling happy, that you have the emotional maturity to state, here's what I need, cut to the chase, state it. That's going to create so much more freedom in him, because instead of spending hours trying to decipher the hidden code of your mind, he can now spend hours figuring out how to make it better. So that's gonna be needed. Now, the more drama in the relationship, the less likely he's going to want to commit to you. It's gonna be fun and exciting for a while, the unconquerable woman, but that type of experience is not one that any man of substance is willing to experience for a long amount of time. Third, admiration. Why is admiration so important? Because just like you want admiration, just like you want your man to see you for who you are and understand you, admiration is a real thing. If you cannot admire the man you're with, he's going to end up sleeping with someone else, which begs the premise, don't be with a man you don't admire. Why? Because if you don't admire him, he's gonna feel it, he's gonna search for it, down the anywhere. He's going to search for that somewhere, and he's going to find it maybe from someone who's not as awesome as you, but who validates him in some way. So be willing to connect to a man that you admire, and then throughout the relationship, just like he should be willing to express that to you, you should be able to clearly, unequivocally express to him what you admire about him and why. Fourth thing he's going to need within the relationship is emotional depth. And what is emotional depth in the meaning of a relationship? I'd say one powerful way to describe it is friendship. And I'm not talking about a Facebook friend. I'm talking about a real friend who knows you, understands you, gets you, witnesses you, holds space for you, just like you would expect for him to know you, understand you, and hold space for you. Again, not rocket science, but not the most important thing many women focus on when they connect to a guy. When they connect to a guy, sometimes the chemistry is the most important thing they focus on, leaving aside the friendship. And when you leave aside the friendship, which is the foundation of the relationship, then this will not last. It's a house built on shitty sand, not even sand, okay? Last one, last but not least, is sexual expression. And sexual expression, my dears, includes a combination of two things. One, safety; two, adventure; two, opposing forces. Why? Safety to be yourself, for him to be himself, to express what he wants. You may not have to say yes to what he wants, but don't make him wrong for it. Express, have him, give him the benefit of expressing what he wants, just like he should give you the benefit of expressing what you want. And then the adventure part means figuring out how to fulfill each other's ideas and fantasies and deepest needs in a way that's healthy but also fun. Because when things become too stale, when things become too monotonous, when things become too predictable, then there's something missing in that powerful dynamic of chemistry that goes beyond friendship to create something sustainable. Friendship is amazing, but if you only have a friendship, you have a brother or a sister, you want friendship and more. So you start with a friendship, not with a more, and then you develop the more along the way. Hope this is helpful, useful, and insightful. If this is helpful and insightful to you, and you want to understand how do you actually create this kind of relationship, how do you attract this kind of man, then you're in luck, because the first link on the description of this video is going to show you how to do just that. All you do is click on the first link, enter name and email, and then you'll be redirected to a free training that I created for you. Now, if this video is helpful, then please click like and thumbs up. And last but not least, if you find that you want not videos, but help and hand-holding through your unique process, because you have no time to waste and because you were deciding that this is gonna be the moment where you go all in and find your soulmate, and you want my help, second link on the description will allow you to connect with me and find out if we're a great fit to work together. Thank you so much for connecting with me. As always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.